guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Erica and this is Gypsy Cowgirl Tarot. I'm a psychic medium, oracle, and prophetess, you guys. Which means I don't need the cards. I feel the energies, see things, all that. But I use the cards to connect and I love tarot, obviously. It's beautiful. But anyways, today, you guys, I am feeling extreme anxiety again with the masculines. Like my palms are sweaty today, which is so weird. They're nervous. They're nervous that they're gonna lose this opportunity again. They're nervous that they're gonna miss their chance with the feminine. They're nervous that, you know, they have to have conversations that are uncomfortable that will hurt people. They are really, really struggling with this, you guys. Like it's just really getting to them right now. And it's like, it's an energy where they're feeling like, excuse the vulgarity, but shit or get off the pot. I mean, that's for lack of a better term, like that's what it is. And so anyway, so they're nervous. I think I'm going to start with a couple like messages from a higher, you know, from a higher level, like spiritually, from the higher realms. Okay, let's see. See, look at this. Right when I split the deck, see, the Holy Grail, inner discovery, finding sacredness. You are what you seek. See, that's like the Ace of Cups. The masculine already knows, you know, their fulfillment. They already know where their fulfillment is, what their fulfillment is, all of that. But they do have to, in order to achieve the Holy Grail, in order to have this Ace of Cups, right? In order to do that, they have to go through these motions and they're nervous with it. You know, so sacred inner space, sacral chakra, tenderness, and sensuality. The lower chakras are like going crazy right now because of the, it's because of these connections, like the chemistry between them, the heat between them, the passion between them. A lot of, sexual activations, let's just say that. Okay, sacral chakra though, the feminine is really tapping into their sensuality, into their sacral in that way, like their tenderness, their creativity, their passion. They're in the flow. They just, you know, they're in empress mode. Okay, the masculine is learning about their sacred inner space. They're learning about their sacral chakra. I did a whole reading the other day and the title of it was like something about their sacral chakra. Tenderness, sensuality. So when they think of the feminine, it's all of that. The lotus, you know, it's like how the feminine has transformed them, how the feminine has brought light into their life. See, the lotus, the light. The feminine is the one that gives life, you know. They see, you know, having a home with you. It's like turning a house into a home. Anyways, they're really yearning, like aching for the feminine right now. Like they're so turned on by the feminine. They, like you guys catch my drift. Like when they're alone, they're thinking of the feminine. When they have sex with karmics, they picture the feminine, they think of the feminine. It's like all of that. The Holy Grail came back. Right, guys? Didn't I shuffle? Didn't I shuffle? I put it back in because it was in the middle and then I shuffled. I'm pretty sure. So anyways, okay, let's see what else. What else? Spirit, show us the divine truth, the highest and greatest good of the collective, please. Oh, this one wants to come out right here. Arcturian light codes. Evolutionary downloads, recalling power and future thinking. See? The divine masculine is so in their head about like the big picture right now, the long term of their life. See, like for, they've been closing out a lot of major life cycles and they've been beginning a lot of major life cycles. See, the one like puzzle piece is their partner, their ride or die, right? Their ride or die, their one that's always riding shotgun, holding their hand when they're driving, you know, it's that like, but also like holding their hand through life, helping them navigate through life. That's what this is. They're getting so much like downloads and all of that right now from, you know, from from the divine. But they're, you know, with their awakening and all that. But anyways, they're starting to feel stuff, and they are, they're really like, I guess I want to say, sorry guys, I was going to look for another deck real fast that I was like being called to grab, but I couldn't think of it. They're thinking, see, with this future, it's recalling power, future thinking. They are recalling their power from the feminine solar plexus chakra, and they are thinking of the future. It's big picture thinking, future thinking. It's all of that. And then we have the divine matrix, interconnectedness, synchronicities, and God incidences. See, they are seeing so many synchronicities. They are seeing so many signs. They are seeing so many, like just everything is pointing them in the direction of the feminine. So anyways, all right. I did not. And then memories of Atlantis, spiritual acceleration, progress, technology. They're being spiritually accelerated. Remember I've been talking about quantum leaping. There's that too. Many of you guys are connected to Atlantis. Many of you guys are connected to the Arcturians. Okay. Progress. There's progress being made here because of their big picture thinking. They are seeing so many synchronicities. They're understanding how we're all like interconnected. They're feeling the oneness, the connectedness to that feminine. It's all that. Okay, cool. All right. All right. So let's do some tarot. Let's do some tarot. Messages, please show the truth of today, please, for the collective, the divine truth. What is going on in these divine masculines' lives at this time? That one fell out. Seven of Pentacles. Thinking, planning. It's also divine timing. Seven of Pentacles for me is timing. It's like because you've planted the seed, you've sown the seed, you've tended to the seed has grown, the fruit is here. It's time, it's harvest. See, King of Swords. All right, they feel coldness around their energy today. They feel coldness around their, you know, their partnerships. They are being rigid, holding back. They're defensive. They feel like they're on the defense constantly too. They're thinking, a lot of thinking going on here with the King of Swords and the Seven of Pentacles. Okay, so, I mean, what, why are they, you know, what are they thinking about? What are they thinking about? How to move things forward. They feel stuck. They feel stuck on their throne. On how to move things forward. That's what they're thinking about. They know it's time. Time is of the essence. You know, that's the nervousness. See, he almost looks nervous. Like he knows he needs to make moves. He knows he needs to communicate, speak truths, cut things out. But he's like sitting there. It's like sitting in idle, but thinking. See, sitting back in idle. Which way do I go? Indecision. Indecision on how to get single. See, they've had enlightenment. They know it. They get it. They see it. But they don't understand yet how they're going to obtain it. But at this time, they are not happy or content with anything in their life. Like they are feeling discontentment. Oh my gosh. This is like, yeah, see, they know that everything in their life that they're not happy with at this time is blocking their happily ever after. Told you, they're defensive. They're on the defense. I felt that. They feel like everything's like attacking them. Like people are like creating issues in their life, and like they feel like their back's against a wall. But they also know that they're on the ledge. They have to make a move. They have to like fight back, push back. Clarify the Hangman, please, and the Seven of Wands. Chariot. victory, movement forward. That, you know, why they are, while they're feeling stuck, like in these situations or where whatever is going on in their lives, they are doing some serious thinking though. It's almost as if like they're hanging back, waiting for the right moment. But then again, it's like, there's never a right moment. See, they're going to end up doing something impulsive today, this week. They're going to do something impulsive that brings them their wish fulfillment, their destiny, their victory, and their new passionate beginning. So they're not going to be able to hang back much longer, you guys. Like it's really, you know, I always like to use the analogy of a basketball. Like when you try to hold a basketball underwater, if you hold that basketball underwater, like it's really hard to do that. And the minute you let it go, it's going to fly back up and, you know, possibly smack you in the face. That's what they've come to. See, these realizations. Okay. All right. Cool. Let's see. What else? Let's clarify. Tell me about the impulse, the Knight of Swords. We're going to clarify the Knight of Swords. See, and I do feel too that this Seven of Wands is them fighting back. See, because the Chariot is victory after battle. It's after battle. So they're fighting back. And this Knight of Swords is charging into battle. You see, he's charging, flying super fast. This is happening quick. Whoa. These just flipped over. Illuminate and risky. It says unprotected sex, sexual disease, partner to partner, unsafe decisions. This is like kind of the energy that they were in before, but like risky. It feels like, again, earlier when I said that they're waiting for the perfect moment, it feels like they feel like something's risky. Like if they make a move right now, it could be risky for some reason, but they're going to take that risk. They're going to do something impulsive. All right. They're going to do something impulsive that it's revealing the truth, confessions, shedding light. They're going to impulsively reveal the truth. See, it's that illumination that gets them unstuck. It's like that last little thread holding them to something. See, they reveal the truth, they confess, it sheds light, and there's no longer this room for denial. There's no longer room for not facing reality, you know. It's very illuminating. Very illuminating. Okay. Tell me about this Seven of Pentacles. Seven of Pentacles. I was going to ask Seven of Pentacles, which I said is like thinking, but it's also timing for me. Protected aura, divine intervention, guardian angel, and shielding. Divine intervention. That's divine timing. That's divine timing. Drama. Drama. See, this for me right here is drama. It's drama. It's like all these angry wands flying at them constantly, and they feel like they're constantly on the defense, defending themselves, standing up for themselves. Bottom of the deck, gossip. See, you can't make this stuff up. Drama and then gossip. You know, toxic karmic. Spreading rumors, petty conversations, smearing your image, making you the fool. See, for a lot of you guys, they're talking about you. The karmic creates drama over you. They start fights with the masculine over you. They try to smear your image, your name. Unexpected changes happening here. Super fast too. Because you're their soulmate. You're the one. You're the life partner they seek. Okay. All right. Let's get some messages. Let's get some messages real fast. Messages from the Divine Masculine today for the Feminine. For the Divine Feminine. Show us the Divine Truth, please. I feel like you're on the other side of my every breath. I couldn't handle my true feelings for you, so I kept you as a friend and nothing more. See, they were trying to suppress, just like that basketball, but eventually it flew right back up. Letting you down was the worst decision I ever made. See? They've been working hard, you know, in their career, in their home life, tending to all of their pentacles, all of their 3D things, but they are missing the feminine. It's like all of that is great, but it's not their absolute fulfillment. It hurts to see online that you've moved on with your life. See? And then they say, I'm trying to move on, but thoughts of you still linger and I can't control them. I do say he because, you know, all of the pictures in the tarot, like, that are depicting the masculine are men. I'm trying to move on. It hurts to see that you've moved on. I'm trying to move on. It hurts to see that you've moved on. See, they see this extreme glow up within the feminine's reality and life and within the feminine. The feminine is illuminated with magic, light, and illuminated with spirit, you see, and they can't move on. Everywhere I go, I look around as if you'll magically be there. I'm feeling lost and I don't know what to do about it. I miss looking into your eyes and into your soul. Something about the eyes with a lot of you, that keeps coming up too. I let my ego get in our way. I couldn't let go of my pride, but you saw right through me. You know the truth about me. They love that you can see through them because you just know. And it's deep knowing. And they love that. I can see us having a family and a beautiful life. See, told you guys. I want to be open and honest. Okay. I feel stuck and don't know what to do. That's that right there. You make moves. You use this sword to cut things away. You gather your strength and your power. And you do that to harvest and to move forward. Get out of limbo. Karmic limbo. It's like karmic purgatory. Seriously, that's what it is. I have never been so attracted to someone. Yeah. To come out. I love when we meet up in our dreams. Ooh, yeah, that one's powerful right now. A lot of this happening for you guys. A lot of you guys. Very strong dream stuff. I didn't know what a twin flame was. Now I do. See, you brought them enlightenment, spiritual enlightenment. They have illumination. They know what this is now. My pride and ego hold me back. They're overcoming that. All will be revealed to you very soon. I need courage to face my feelings. See, I literally just said, gather your strength. Cut things away. Be the king, right? It's not rocket science, but it is ascension. It is alignment. So, you know, they need to do this. They need to do this to bring this balance, right? To bring this restoration of balance, the union of hearts, a love connection that divides explanation. Holy shit, literally, I split the deck in half. There's this one. You guys deeply rooted. You guys have had past lives, many past lives. This is twin flame. You guys, this is your higher selves in alignment, together, bonded for eternity. And then you have relationship patterns. I literally just channeled out, gather your strength, and then the strength, I need my courage. And now this, it takes strength to recognize the need for change. See? Masculine. Sending these energies out to the masculine at this time, right? This is what they need. Strength. Gather the strength, the courage of the King of Swords, who is a warrior king. He's the only king with a weapon. And he uses the weapon to cut away people, places, and things that do not serve his best and highest good in his life. And it takes strength to recognize that and to do that and to take action on that. Practice compassion. See things from a fresh perspective. See things from a fresh perspective. Gather your strength. It is card number 15, which is the devil in the major arcana. It's time to get out of the karmic purgatory, the karmic loop, the karmic hamster wheel. See, it's time to take off the mask to reveal the truth. 38 could be an age, you, of your person. But it's time to take off that mask, reveal truth, speak with love and truth. Honesty is essential at this time. It's essential in order for these unions to take place. 38 breaks down to 11, twin flames. This is new beginnings. Love makes the difference. Love helps heal past hurts and provides a sense of security and self-worth. Absolutely. Last message. Back to what you love. Reevaluate your desires. It's time for the masculine to get back to what they love. That's what they're doing. Reevaluating. Thinking. How do I get back to my happiness and out of this darkness? How do I create a new love? This is what's coming in. Miracles and blessings. So, this is what I have for you, my loves. If this was your message, be sure to claim it by liking and subscribing to the channel. If you want to hone in on your own personal situationship, twin flame journey, separation, whatever it is that you guys are going through or you're going through personally, you can email me down below. I can do a live reading with you or send you a recorded reading. I am offering special New Year readings for 2022 because it's a super fucking powerful year, you guys. I can do a 1 hour, 12 month spread, which is $190, but I go through every month predictions, pulling cards, and then I'll also tap into anything else that you want to tap into. Okay. So it's like a kind of double reading. And that's the 1 hour, or you can do a 30 minute for just the 12 months. Okay. And that's just the whole year, which they're both powerful and amazing. Thank you guys for all the donations on the channel. It means the world to me. I love you guys. Thank you for your support, all of your comments. I adore you guys. And you guys can follow me on Instagram, Gypsy Cowgirl Tarot. You can follow me on TikTok, Gypsy Cowgirl Tarot. I just started that. And yeah, happy holidays, you guys. And get ready. These unions are happening left and right. Communication is happening left and right between these divine unions. So, and everyone's going to be on different timelines, so do keep that in mind too. That's the thing with collective readings, right? But anyways, you guys, Take care, and I will see your beautiful faces probably tomorrow.